Good day, everyone. My name is Dusan Radosavljevic. I am from Committee for Space Program Development from Republic of Serbia. And today, now, I will tell you something more about World CanSat Rocketry Championship. A World CanSat Rocketry Championship, hereinafter WCRC, is generally an international competition open to elite competitors from around the world, representing their nations as university student teams or as independent student teams, and winning this event will be considered the highest or near highest achievement in this field. After holding the International CanSat Rocketry Competition in Serbia in October 2019 as a pilot project, Serbia and India agreed to launch the initiative to establish CanSat Rocketry Championship at the global level so that the CanSat Rocketry program can be raised to a higher level, involving even more students and countries, i.e. to make this program got a place in the world that deserves, because there is a lot to be learned through it. Both countries believe that this is very important globally, primarily in terms of education and in promoting space engineering in general. The WCRC was formulated and negotiated among the organizations from six countries: Serbia, India, Italy, Tunisia, Canada, and Peru, hereinafter founders, from October 2019 to January 2020, and they agreed on the aims, structure, and functioning of the WCRC. This event is important for everyone, and for each founder country, and for organizations, institutions, and companies, and most important for education and students, because the CanSat Rocketry program is a vertical type of education compared to the horizontal they have in their studies. Now let's say something about CanSat again. A CanSat is a simulation of real satellite. All components are housed inside a can up to 350 milliliters. CanSat provides an affordable way to gain basic knowledge and skills in space engineering for teachers and students, as well as experience engineering challenges when designing satellites. Students are able to design and build a small electronic payload that can fit into the cans to 350 milliliters. CanSat is launched by rocket, balloon, plane, or drone and delivered in apogee. With the parachute, the CanSat slowly descends to the ground and carries out its mission during descent. For example, measures air pressure and temperature and sends telemetry. By analyzing the data collected by CanSat, students will explore the reasons for the success or failure of its mission. Space engineering learning based on the CanSat rocketry concept enables students to gain hands-on experience through a specific interdisciplinary project. Since this is a space engineering project, teachers and students will gain experience from mission defining, conceptual design, through integration and testing, to launching and actual system operation, i.e. experience from the whole space project cycle, and then participate in the CanSat Rocketry competition with their peers at home country and abroad. One of the main advantages of the CanSat Rocketry concept is its interdisciplinary combination of mathematics, physics, informatics programming, mechatronics, telecommunications, aviation and rocketry, mechanics, etc. CanSat is a simulation of a real, large satellite and contains all the subsystems components as a real satellite, but with limited complexity. Benefits of CanSat rocketry-based education you can see on this slide. CanSat rocketry is an effective education tool for all of this that you can read. Also, Today, almost every country in the higher education system has a CanSat program, so the initiative to establish CanSat Rocketry Championship as the at the global level is additionally justified. As I said, founders are Serbia, India, Italy, Tunisia, Peru, and Canada. Let's say something about common rules. India will be the organizer and host of the CanSat Rocketry competition for Asian and Australian continents as qualification for world finals, which means that India sets all rules for organizing and holding the competition, I mean on competition propositions, number of teams rules in general, participation fee, place, date, rules on site, etc. By the same model, Italy and Serbia will organize together competition for European continent as qualification for world finals. Tunisia will be the organizer and host of the competition for African continent and the Middle East as qualification for world finals. Canada will be the organizer and host of the competition for North American continent as qualification for world finals. Peru will be the organizer and host of the competition for South American continent as qualification for world finals. Serbia will be the organizer and host of the CanSat Rocketry competition for world finals, which means that Serbia sets all rules for organizing and holding the competition based on its capacities and capabilities and by adhering to a common document, which is the basic rules for world finals. With the understanding that each founder country in particular is best aware of the situation on its continent and its own capacities and capabilities, this kind of independence in decision-making and organizing is the best solution, with, of course, continuous mutual cooperation. All founder countries have the adequate experience and the infrastructure, the necessary knowledge and skills. All founder countries will together define the basic rules of the qualification competitions and all other details for the world finals as separate documents, which will change every year for the purpose of development and progress. Each founder country is responsible for its continent and the organization of the competition and has the opportunity, if it wishes, to organize the competition on its continent and with another country from the same continent and on the soil of that country. So the competition may not always be in the same country, but the founder country from that continent must be co-organizer with another country on which the competition is organized. The responsibility of each founder country is to promote, organize, and hold the competition on its continent by the end of the current year. The world finals will be held always next year. More precisely, to invite all students from their continents to the competition. To find the adequate place for this event, both outdoor and indoor. To decide what they will use for lunch, rocket or balloon or drone or plane, and provide lunch permissions, if required, in safety measures, related equipment, staff, and everything else that is necessary to hold the event safe and successful. Material for CanSat assembling is set by India and will be placed on Amazon for sale. Also, all video manuals and handbooks are prepared by India and will be available to every country. Launch equipment, rocket or balloon or drone or plane, is on each founder country. Each year, all founder countries will agree on the basic rules, primarily for flight mission, as a separate document for qualifying competitions across continents, with the aim of making the competitions as similar as possible to all participants worldwide. Each founder country may make certain changes to these basic rules for the purposes of its competition only if such changes will improve the competition itself and will not deviate much from the mentioned aim. Each founder country has the same status in this project. All founder countries are completely equal, therefore all founder countries have the same rights and obligations. Now let's say something about championship phases. The WCRC consists of three phases. Phase 1, which is National CanSat Rocketry Competition as qualification for Continental CanSat Rocketry Competition. In this competition, student teams participate across their own state. If the state does not have a national competition, then all student teams can directly participate in the Continental CanSat Rocketry Competition, which is actually Phase 2. Phase 2 is, as I said, Continental CanSat Rocketry Competition as qualification for World Finals. And Phase 3 is World Finals CanSat Rocketry Competition. Evaluation and scoring in championship phases 2 and 3. I will not mention something about evaluation scoring in championship phase 1 because that depends on each nation, of each country, since that each nation will define its own propositions, main rules, that actually depends on each state. So evaluation scoring and other things will be part of that, are part of that main rules, and WCRC not deal with that. That is on each nation, on each state separately. Okay, evaluation scoring in championship phases 2 and 3. The jury. The jury will be appointed by founder countries and will be comprised of CanSat experts, education experts, engineers, and scientists who will evaluate the team's performances during phases 2 and 3. The jury will typically have 3 to 5 members, and their fields of expertise can vary from science to engineering or education. The jury board will be usually comprised of these 5 points, as you can see on this slide. Scoring. Performance in the following areas will be evaluated during phases 2 and 3. Technical achievement. The jury will take into account how the teams obtained the results, how reliable and robust the CanSat was, visual appearance, and how the CanSat performed. Scientific value. The scientific value of the team's missions and the team's scientific skills will be evaluated. This includes the scientific relevance of the mission, the quality of the technical reporting, both written and oral, and the team's scientific understanding that will be assessed from the team's ability to analyze and interpret results appropriately. Professional competences. The jury will assess the team's collaboration and coordination, adaptability and communication skills. Outreach. The team will be rewarded with additional points based on explanation, how the project is communicated to the local community, taking into account web pages, blogs, presentations, promotional material, media coverage, etc. Marking scheme. The overall balance between the items to be evaluated is as follows. You can see this in detail on this slide. Prizes for phases 2 and 3 are first prize, second prize, third prize, and the following rule will apply. A team cannot receive more than one prize. Finally, we came to quotas for World Finals. A total of 37 teams can compete in the World Finals. On this slide, you can see the quotas for each continent, by each continent. Each team can consist of a minimum of 3 members and a maximum of 5 members. Please, if you have some questions, please just send me an email, and thank you very much for your attention. Please stay well and stay safe. Bye.